The First Crusade, Episode 15, The Holy Lance, 1098. Baldwin of Bologna's capture of Edessa proved helpful to the Crusaders in another way as well. On his way to Antioch, the Turkish Atabeg of Mosul, Kerbuka, stopped for 3 days to besiege Edessa, delaying his progress. When he failed at this task, the Turk continued on, intent on destroying the Crusader army camped outside of Antioch. But as we learned in our last episode, the Crusaders had already captured the city, and by the time Kerbuka's forces began to arrive before Antioch's walls on June 5th, the Crusaders had already firmly established themselves within the city. Only the citadel on Mount Silpius remained in Turkish hands, and this Kerbuka bolstered by installing it with a garrison of his own. The army Kerbuka commanded was awesome to behold, so large that in fact it could fully blockade the city. Antioch had just been through a months-long siege, and so food was scarce within her powerful walls. Penned in by Kerbuka's troops, the Crusaders once again faced the very real prospect of starvation. Meanwhile, far away in Anatolia, another sizable army was on its way to Antioch, this one Byzantine, and headed by Emperor Alexius Comnenus, who had finally elected to bring aid to his beleaguered Latin allies. However, at Philomelion, the emperor encountered one Stephen, Count of Blois, who had fled Antioch just before its fall. Stephen, eager to justify his premature departure from the siege, assured Alexius that the whole Christian army had already been destroyed, and thus the cause of the crusade completely lost. Alexius was perhaps a little too eager to trust Stephen's word, and quickly elected to abandon his mission. Together, the Byzantine emperor and the Count of Blois picked up and headed back to the safety of Constantinople. Meanwhile, from the walls of Antioch, the Crusaders, under the de facto leadership of Bohemond, were gazing down at the enormous army of Kerbuka, enfolding them like the coils of a serpent. It seemed incredible that, after their astounding capture of the powerfully fortified city, Christ's warriors would perish all the same within their prize. Naturally, everyone in the army was looking toward Bohemond for a solution, the man who time and time again had carried the day. The Norman giant was weighing his options carefully, and already formulating a plan to defeat the mighty Kerbuka. Meanwhile, the desperation of the situation caused many crusaders to pray for a miracle. One southern French priest called Peter Bartholomew approached Count Raymond of Toulouse with tales of a vision from St. Andrew. The saint, Peter insisted, had assured him that buried somewhere beneath Antioch's magnificent cathedral of St. Peter was the lance that had been used at Calvary to pierce the side of Christ. If the crusaders found this relic and carried it into battle against Kerbuka, God, according to Peter Bartholomew, would grant them victory. Although many were skeptical of Peter's story, others were convinced by it, among them the pious old Count Raymond, who on June 15th ordered an excavation beneath the altar of St. Peter's Cathedral. Peter himself was among those digging in the dirt, and at one point Peter cried out and scrambled out of the hole, holding an old iron shard and shouting that he discovered the precious relic. News of Peter's discovery exploded throughout the city. A few skeptics remained, such as Bishop Adhemar of Lepuy. But for the average rank-and-file soldier, this could be nothing but a sign from God. Considering the gravity of the situation, it was exactly what the Crusaders needed. Morale was boosted, and the weary, hungry Christian soldiers were convinced now that they would indeed triumph over Kerbuka's hordes. Whatever Peter Bartholomew pulled out of that hole in St. Peter's that day, there can be no doubt that the spiritual impact on the Christian soldiers was profoundly positive. It came at the right time as well, for the leaders of the army had decided on a very daring and dangerous strategy, a full-on battle with Kerbuka. In the next episode, we'll discover what happened in this decisive Battle of Antioch.